I love it. I love it. I am pumped up, Adam. Let's go. How's everybody
Let's go.
doing? ClockMen, Moonshine.
Let's go. Let's go.
Not bad yourself.
What's up, guys? How's everybody going?
Are we ready to do this? Ready to learn?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Let's start it. We got some people joining us. It's a little slow today, but we can soft start it. Welcome, guys. Happy to have you. Interesting to hear what you guys got going. No, for a fact, you bought two upcoming collections that is hyped. So I'm excited to hear what you guys are doing, or from hyping. And as always, if anyone has any questions or anything they want to discuss, just come up, raise your hand, ask these projects whatever you want to ask. Yeah, let's start it. I want to start with just a quick introduction from you guys. Tell us a quick brief about your projects and who I'm speaking to, and then we can dive deeper into each one of your projects, and of course have some good discussions by the end. So if it's okay, I want to start with Clockman. Just give us a quick introduction and welcome.
Yeah, sure, guys. So I am the founder of ClockMen NFT. I am also doing the art aspects of it. So I designed them myself. And I'm also helping out with a lot of the marketing and branding aspect and community creation. So I'm kind of just filling in places everywhere I need to be. And yeah, I guess I'll just dive right in. So I'll break it down into kind of like three main stages. So for our first stage, we're essentially creating an ecosystem for Web3 creators to come together and create. So we have many different networking chats built into our private Discord. So on launch, after we launch, that'll all be holders access only. So you won't be able to see any of that stuff if you don't hold our NFT. But so there's a lot of different channels like creator consultation with like other agency owners, and we're gonna have like Web3 job listings and many different professional networking chats. So basically, if you're a creator in the space and you're looking to hire someone, you could automatically come into our Discord, get your role, see like you can choose whether you want a developer, marketer, and then you can go through that chat and choose whoever you think is the best. And you can obviously there will be certifications and training courses and all of that. And yeah, so our second stage. It's going to be raffles. So 70% of our royalties are going to go towards our raffle system, where I will right now be buying many NFTs on the secondary market, Magic Eden, and then we're going to list them on our quantum marketplace. So we have a website that hasn't been released yet, but it's going to be the inside of a clock tower. It's pretty much done. We're just waiting because once that gets released, pretty much all of the information about our project gets released. So we still want to drive a little bit of that like curiosity. And for our third stage, I can't dive into too much because we haven't really told many people about that. And but I will say it involves staking, but it adds something a little new to it, but that you find in our website as well. And we are a new project, so this is my first ever NFT collection, but we have many people on our team that have done this many, many times with successful campaigns, and right now a bunch of them are solid floors, and I'm looking forward to what we can do and how far we can go. And it's honestly, when you're looking at it, like from what I just described, it kind of sounds like an agency, but we're not a full-on agency. We're not asking for money from anybody. We're actually willing to pay for some of these projects that we hear about, and we'll become venture capitalists basically. And yeah, if you guys want to talk about like some of the team members or go into anything else, I'll too. But I think we're gonna let the other guy speak.
Thank you. That's great. And also, I like this because there is a lot of job opportunities and a lot of people working in Web3 in the NFT space. But there isn't really any way place to go. Like, how do I learn marketing in Web3, for example, which is a very special type of marketing? So, I'm cool to see how you tackle this.
Thank you.
Awesome. All right. Also, welcome to Moonshine. Thanks for coming on.
Thank you guys for having us. I'm V-Rock. I'm the one behind the Moonshine account. I'm one of four founders of Moonshine K9s. Our pitch is simple, and you know we'll deep dive into it a little bit later, but we're bringing our Irish premium whiskey brand to Web3.
That's a perfect pitch. Exciting. Are you a big whiskey drinker yourself then?
Yes.
Awesome. All right. I've read some. I've already been reading your product, but I have questions. I have questions for you, my friend. But let's start it. Let's dive deep. Let's hear everything. Let's start it with ClockMen. You talked a little bit about but I'm curious, how did you get into this? Do you have a lot of experience in these different, like, let's say, marketing, development, stuff like that? Do you have who's behind the team? What's your experience?
So, can you repeat that last part? Sorry, I glitched out a little.
So you're going to work with educating.
Who are we working with to do that stuff? So
yeah, right, the team. Tell me about the team.
Okay, so right now there's me, the founder, who's mainly doing the art stuff and management of Twitter and all that, and branding. And then we have the co-founder. So he's a young entrepreneur who's a coder. He taught himself how to code at a really young age, and he's doing the website and smart contract. We will be using another person's launchpad, so we're thinking either like Mercury or Soulport to use another launchpad. We'll figure that out later down the line, but we know we have many places to look for to do that. And we have a community manager who is his own agency owner, and he has been a part of probably over 25 projects in the space. He's working on probably like 3 or 4 currently, and he's been around for a while, and he has a lot of knowledge. And I don't know if you guys know the NFT Academy that well. Do any of you? No? All right. Well,
I don't
know it.
It's kind of a project similar to what we're doing, and like that's like where I kind of like initially found him. So he's very important piece of our project, and he's handling a lot of like the training courses stuff, as I said. So he is full-time, not full-time, but he does a lot of the community creation. So he created the Discord and everything, and he's also a marketer, so he helps a little bit on the consultation side for that. And we have like 3 or 4 collab managers right now running. Right now we've only been doing Discord collabs, and we'll tweet about those soon. We've collabed with like Cats on Crack, Deegan Ape Academy, Ghost Kid Dao, and we got some others coming in soon. And we'll make that public. And for some other team members, we have our operations manager, who is mainly from the Web2 world. He's very successful in the real estate and architecture world, and has his own firm in New York City. And he owns like over probably 2.3 million square feet. And he's probably one of the main like venture capitalists we have for our team. And then we do have other marketers that we work with on Twitter. So we just partnered up with, so we have a new marketing strategist named DeFi Princess. So she's going to be helping a lot of the DeFi people in our Discord. And yeah, I think we'll continue to grow. We have like 3 or 4 mods as well, working around the clock, as they should be. And yeah, that's pretty much our team right now, and I'm sure we will get bigger as we go along.
Awesome. So you're going to do a lot of the education, like in-house with the people on the team.
Yeah. So like the coder would be helping with development classes. Like he would be helping other developers in that channel, and I would be helping like digital artists, like with classes with that. And then Dean would be helping marketers. And so it's kind of like wherever the position that is needed, we can fill it in because we kind of have all aspects.
Awesome. All right. So also, let's talk about the collection. You have the ClockMen, right? How does this tie into to education?
Well, so it's a lot of it is to do with my watch addiction, but there's also a lot of like philosophy behind like how we can control time. And once we can control time, we can kind of forge our own path. And I'm kind of relating that to Web3, like we must dial in. It's kind of like a saying for we must work. We must put in the work to get where we want to. We must and kind of provide for our future. And the only way like a true builder is actually born is through mastery of their own time. So they must kind of work to a point where it just becomes normal to work a 12-hour day and feel fine about it because you love it so much. And it's and that's like kind of what I want to do. I want to get a place where all of those aspiring, like ambitious people in one spot, and we don't really have anybody just there looking to create something in 3 weeks and not really do anything with it after. Like we're going to have people coming together and creating lifetime partnerships, like basically marriages almost.
Cool, cool. I like that you have a thought, a big thought process behind this, both the art and the concept.
And like thank you. Right?
Also, if anyone else has any question, and of course, and Moonshine, if you have a question for ClockMen as well, feel free. Awesome. So the you called it the workshops, right? The educations. Is this going to be in Discord, or do we plan on making a separate platform for courses and stuff?
So I think it's mainly going to be posted in like the private Discord channels, but I think we'll have links to other places. So like it won't necessarily be all of our information as well. Like if we find something that's really valuable on the internet, we will reach out to that person and ask them if we can show this to our community.
All right. Awesome. Are you going to have, like, I remember we had a project on, it was an ETH project, but this was maybe 2 weeks ago, who was also doing not this type of Web3 education, more like personal development, but they were going to have, I think they called it learn to earn. So basically you get every step you take in their courses and stuff, you get rewards, which is basically a SPL. Right?
So yeah, we're
something like this.
Yeah, we're trying to figure out a way so we can do learn to earn, sorry about that, as well as like work to earn and kind of combine them in a sense. And I know typically they're two different things, but I think we can figure out a way to hopefully combine those.
Yeah, why not? We're in Web3, right?
Yep.
This is the way. Gotta earn the tokens.
Zero limitations.
Yeah. No, it's cool. I love it. So what about the collection? Like, have you decided on the size and the price and the date, everything?
So for collection size, I was thinking, well, I want it to be a countdown. So I was thinking like maybe something like 3, 2, 1, 0. So it's kind of brings a lot of the suspense kind of drive to press that mint button because you don't really know what's going to happen and nobody does. And that kind of countdown gives you that little extra incentive to press that button.
Nice. So we talked, is the NFT is going to be the access to these courses, or hold the benefits. What's the benefit of holding a ClockMen?
So the holder benefit is basically every day when we're yard off by simply going into our website and we're going to be raffling off these different NFTs, and you can simply just press enter and you have a chance of winning an NFT every single day. And after that, we have extreme networking, like I said, so that's built in for you. And that's that network is the thing that will probably get you to a place in Web3 that you want to be at the fastest. Like, and like knowing these people in the space and kind of understanding how everything works, that is what will let you go on to the next level. And like, I feel like there's going to be a lot of people that are going to come to us and say, we want to build an NFT project. And I'm just going to have to say, like, I'm sorry, you are not in a place where you're able to do that. And if you were to do that, it would have to be extremely low price, low supply, because you just don't have the full knowledge of the space and what an animal it is. It's just a different breed entirely compared to any other business world in the world.
Yeah. It would be cool to see if you could connect it. Like, you could make certificates, which could also be an NFT or something, right?
Certificates. Well, we're working on something like that as well. We'll come out with something public with that soon. Well, also, I think that'll start up probably like once we actually have our holders and we know who's in the Discord lately.
Take tests. And then when I reach out to, so you can connect me with Moonshine and say that Adam have this community certificate from us, so you can trust us with this guy.
Exactly.
Right, perfect. I guess any questions? What are you most excited on this collection?
Sorry, what was that? Did you ask me a question, or were you asking another speaker?
I was asking you. What are you most excited with this collection right now?
Oh, most excited for right now? Right now, I'm so excited for our website to release. We just plugged in like all the animations. It's finally like come to life, and I think once we. That's everybody. We're going to have a lot more recognition and people will actually understand what our project is about. So that's just more of an incentive to stay with us through the process, have those notifications on, and be ready for anything.
Okay.
I don't know if I missed it. Did you say when you're planning to mint, what your price is and what your supply is yet?
So I said the supply, I was thinking a countdown like 3210, so 3,210. And then mint price, it would be between 1 and 2 SOL, no higher than 2. Depends, like we're still waiting, the market's still changing every day. What was the last one?
When,
that's... Like, we don't want to release that information specifically yet, but that will be released probably, like, a week before we actually launch. So I'll tell you guys we have more than another week.
Okay, so, like, you plan on launching, like, within the next month or so?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Are you guys doxed, by chance?
So we're waiting for, you know, Aldermages?
Yeah.
So we were going to, like, once our website's fully out, we were going to do a collab with them and dox ourselves with them.
So, and you also mentioned that your price may be 1 to 2 SOL. How much money are you guys trying to raise off the collection? I guess that would tell us what mint price is.
How much money I'm looking to raise? Me, personally, I'm just looking to make sure that my investors get paid more than what they put in. So in order to do that, probably need to make, because they're each getting 75%, the two main investors, and for them to make up for what they spent, we need to make like around $200,000.
All right. Sorry,
Adam. I was doing the math on that. So at 2 SOL at $35, that's $224,000. So, and you said you need to raise about $2K just to pay them back, or
no, that's
and be comfortable.
That's be well off. Like that's best. Like that's what we want. That's for them to be paid. Like, and them to be well off and be satisfied, and everything would be perfect.
Okay. Well, once you guys release everything. Are the two people that are getting the 15%, is any of their information, are they angel investors? Are they going to be in like your white paper or anything like that?
So yeah, one of them is the operations manager and he'll be like in our website, doxed everything. And the other one is actually just the wife of that person. So I didn't feel like it was necessary to put that in.
Okay. So it's one, I guess you could say one family is in, investing 15% of the company?
Yes.
Dicky, I didn't know you were such a math.
I'm a numbers guy, and when I mean, because numbers is the only thing that really makes sense. Because like, no matter what language they're in, they're all the same.
So yeah,
I do math like that.
It's nice. It's nice. All right, ClockMen. Anything else you want to share? I want to talk some whiskey. We're gonna get back to ClockMen as well, but anything last you want to share?
Well, I'm actually excited to hear about this whiskey as well, but I'll think of some stuff and I'll be back.
Right. What do you say, B-Rock? Should we talk some whiskey? No?
He just put a part a second ago. Technical difficulties?
Oh, I'm sorry. My mic was off. I'm sorry. I had a whole like hype speech and everything, but I was going to just say, yes, I'm ready for the whiskey talk. Thank you guys for having me, ClockMen. Love what you guys are working on. I'd love to chat a little bit more in the DM. It's simple. Our product, Irish whiskey. So we're a 1920 style prohibition dog shaking up the whiskey market. We've established partnerships in the US, the UK, and the EU that our whiskey itself will be live in 33 states in the US. We should have bottles in hand by the end of this year, or early of January 2023. And we are giving out free bottles of whiskey, discounts for holders for life. If outside of the free bottles, we are still currently working on if we would be doing additional free bottles, whether it's quarterly, semi-annually, or annually in itself. And we will be doing a reward system that we are still trying to figure out with legal from profits of the whiskey side or the whiskey brand. That's really it. I mean, I can get into the backstory a little bit about how we came about this, or I can deep dive a little bit more about the whiskey itself. It's up to you guys.
Yes.
Could we deep dive into whiskey itself, please?
Sure. So for me to actually do that, are you a whiskey drinker?
No, I'm allergic to pretty much all alcohols, but I do know a lot about alcohol and whiskey.
All right. So our whiskey itself is a ready established gold medal winning whiskey. So more or less, we actually seeked out partnerships with distilleries. We reached out to a few in the U.S., Scotland, Ireland, and we ultimately decided to partner up with this distillery called Northern Distillery in Locust County, Ireland. They just don't have the capital to get their product out. So they will now be moving forward producing our whiskey, which is called Bark Whiskey. And a little bit about the taste, for those that are whiskey drinkers, those that are not, this is the description that we were able to kind of put together about the whiskey itself. So our whiskey is a superb triple distilled Irish whiskey, patiently aged in bourbon casks with a cherry cask finish to unlock the unique characteristics of the whiskey. The flavors open with hints of toasted oats, fresh yellow apple, and warm cinnamon spice with drops of dried vine fruits. The finish is one of nutty, vanilla, and rich creaminess on the palate. The blend combines the sweet softness of grain whiskey and the lively citrus of the maltski to deliver a winning combination. So basically in Ireland, they've already been, they've won competitions for their whiskey. They just don't have the capital to become a global brand. And this is how we're signing an exclusive contract with them that for moving forward, they will be producing our whiskey and only our whiskey itself. And we will be bringing it to the global market.
Okay. Just shoot.
So I know you're getting the whiskey and everything from Ireland, but where is the business incorporated? Where is everybody?
So the business, sure. So the business, if you go into our Discord under updates, we actually have provided the legal documentation so far of the registered business itself. We are located, the business itself is registered in Delaware. Myself and the artist Frosty, actually he's publicly doxed in our chats multiple times, putting up like works of art that he's done for Google, Delta, some body painting of models for Fashion Week. And Mad Max, which is in the crowd, he's located in Florida. Little Smoke is located in the UK. And our NFT project, Moonshine K9s, is a registered business in the British Virgin Islands.
For taxes and everything, smart.
Yeah. Yeah, we actually have three different sets of legal teams. So we have our NFT side, our alcohol permit side, which we're currently pending with our TTV, our import and wholesale license. Just a little bit background about that real quickly. So we are actually becoming our own importer and wholesaler, which will allow us for any other projects out in the space that are, you know, looking to import in any of the countries or states that we are live and able to sell alcohol in. Instead of them having to go through that entire legal process, we're actually able to onboard them, and under our Moonshine Industries umbrella, they're able to, you know, be able to rush to market a lot sooner than us.
So you guys must have been working on this for a long time then. I mean, to get all those legalities, all your T's crossed and your I's dotted. How long you guys been working?
So we've actually been working on it since July. So we've been working on the project itself since May. But legal-wise, and the reason why we actually chose the whiskey itself, we're partnered with Trust Labs. We had an advisory call with them back in June, and you know, they kind of just said, hey, your project's shit. You're doing everything that everybody else does. Nothing stands out. Why would you want to be an investor yourself? Like, do you kind of feel, you know, you would want to invest in this project? And we, you know, and they were right. And we went back to the drawing board. We, you know, we spent another week, hours upon days, kind of going back and forth on what we were doing. And this concept that we came up with was a wine cellar. So it's like a secret DAO that the community would not know about, that we would just be randomly airdropping NFTs to our key members. And the idea kind of kicked in my head because my family, back in Macedonia, in Eastern Europe, most people don't know where the country is, actually has their own winery and brandy distillery. And it's not actually brandy, but it's the easiest way for me to talk about it. It's actually, the best description would actually be moonshine. They use it for fever remedies, you know, swollen ankles, and they do it to get drunk. I mean, my 96-year-old grandmother did it. She took 3 shots every morning before she passed away and got out of bed. So we then kind of said, well, you know, wine's an oversaturated market that, you know, people, it's difficult to get your foot in the door to be a well-established global brand. Moonshine itself, you know, people don't drink that on the norm. You don't go to a bar, a pub, a lounge, a nightclub, a restaurant saying, yeah, let me get some moonshine. And from there, we, you know, all of us are actually avid whiskey drinkers, minus Frosty. He's actually not a drinker, our artist. And that's how we kind of seeked out the proper partnerships. And since then, we've spoken to, I don't even know how many legal firms to find the correct ones. And we, you know, we finally settled upon everything to the point that, you know, all we're waiting on is the bottles to be imported itself, which was holding us up. And we're actually dropping the announcement later today. We finally heard back from our label design. They had last week submitted some proofs for the label approvals, weren't too fond of them. So we actually sent back some suggestions, and we will be releasing the community itself for them to actually decide what our bottles will look like. And that's what's actually holding us up, because each label that you put on a bottle needs to be approved proper agency before you can actually import the product into the country.
That makes sense. Man, that sounds like a hell of a process. Do you guys have your mint date and your price and everything set up, or are you guys waiting until all of that's done to announce all that stuff?
So we've kind of planned it out. As of right now, we have a tentative penciled in date of October 10th. For date, we haven't decided on a collection size yet or mint size. And the reason it being is we're actually kind of figuring out the mint funds is not something that's like necessary to further the project. And this is why we're trying to do everything before the mint, just to show the community that, you know, we're always going to be here. It's the predominantly most of our mint funds will all go to marketing the brand itself and allowing us to expand globally faster. And the reason it being is, you know, yes, we are giving out free bottles, but if you're in select countries that we don't have proper licenses for, we actually cannot provide you with a bottle at the current time. And this is how we came up with the reward system to kind of reward those holders that aren't going to be able to have our whiskey, you know, right away in hands. But mint price and collection size, we actually don't have set in stone. We actually do at the current time have over 500 and something attributes, to the point that we've been generating the collection where we have enough art to run a 20,000 collection. Now, I'm not saying that I'm not even anything over 10,000. It's just that we have the art where, you know, a lot of projects with compared to attributes, they might have a lot of overlapping attributes where one thing might be different versus another NFT. We have way too many attributes that a lot of them typically do not overlap to actually look pretty much the same.
Well, now that you mentioned that, I was part of a project that kind of did the same. And what they did is they went through and they handpicked all like the super cool ones. Like, so there wasn't very many commons and everything. I don't know if that's something maybe you guys thought about, since you've already got them, you know, you could just make the whole collection.
Oh yeah. We actually started generating the collection. And we've actually been going through them, obviously, of course, just to make sure that all which attributes line up with not, so that, you know, of course, that if somehow, like, you know, we have some hats that depending on the ear, whether the ear needs to be present or not, actually, you know, and we've been going through all of it and handpicking some, and then we've been dropping a lot of sneak peeks as well. And I can pin some up to the top. And these just are just some that are randomly generated through, I believe it's NFT art. But I forgot the website. I'm not the one that generates it. I'm more of the front end guy, the voice behind the mic.
Obi, did you have a question?
Yeah, I did. I have actually two. First, what countries do you have licenses for distribution for the whiskey? And secondly, do you have already marketing plan set in stone for the whiskey using the funds from the mint?
Yep. So just the most recent. So yes, technically, as of right now, we have all partnerships established from the distillery to bottling to fulfilling the, like, filling up the whiskey to shipping them on containers to the US or getting transportation from Ireland to the UK and all of our other warehouse facilities and the United States. So we are pretty much ready to go from A to Z, minus the import license that's still pending and then the label approval. And we do already have marketing companies that are contracted with us that basically are just waiting for, you know, the bottles to actually start being sold itself. You know, we don't want to start a marketing campaign before people can actually try the whiskey itself. And we do plan on purchasing some smaller bottles, like sample size bottles, about 250 milliliters. And we are looking to do about 50 to 100 sample bottles before mint to actually send them out to community members to, for themselves to try the whiskey. And I'm sorry, I think I missed your first question.
Yeah, what countries have you done or have licenses for distribution for?
Gotcha.
Already established?
I'm sorry, yeah. So the United States, and the reason I say 33 states is because each of the 50 states are basically considered its own country. They all have their own, you know, alcohol selling permits, licenses, rules, regulations. And the final 17 that are kind of excluded are what we call control states, where it's not just applying for a permit and having legal, you know, fill out some documentation and we're approved to start, you know, reaching out to retailers, wholesalers. They're a lot stronger and longer and lengthy of a process And I always bring up Pennsylvania because they're actually probably one of the most complicated ones, where you just can't decide if you're going to be selling whiskey or anything in their state. You actually have to get, you have to actually appear before their board, and their board decides whether or not your alcohol is good enough to be sold in their state. And then, actually, I'm just pulling up the workflow for, we are going to be live in the UK, and we're also going to be live in the European Union. As well, those are a lot easier permits. It's just literally just a single form that permits needed to be taken out that we are able to start selling our whiskey in those countries.
Thank you for your answer.
You're welcome.
Nice. It sounds like you have a business behind this, very ready to go, and which is always very good in a NFT project, especially in these times.
Thank you. Yeah, I mean, we wanted to bring our, we wanted to show the holders that, and the community itself, that, you know, we're not just saying, hey, this is an idea that we have and we would love to do, and if you purchase our NFT, I promise you will figure it out. No, this is saying, hey, we have an actual product. We actually have our licenses intact, ready to go. We have three different legal teams, you know, figuring everything we need out to make sure everything that we're doing is legally correct and cannot be, you know, eventually later on down the road, the SEC and come after us. You know, we want to show them that we mean business. We've already figured it out. It's either you come along with us for the ride, you know, whether or not they decide to kind of hold, they want to flip on secondary, that's all up to them. But, you know, we want to show them that, you know, this is what we've done. It's already there for you.
Yeah, and what's the, I don't know if we talked about this, but how do the holders benefit in this whiskey ecosystem?
Perfect. So we're going to be doing kind of like three different tiered things. Originally, we are going to be giving out free bottles of whiskey. And when like I said, it all depends on which countries we are licensed in. To those holders, they would actually be delivered at no cost to them, a free bottle of whiskey. From there, we also are going to be doing discounts for life. So we are going to have a direct-to-consumer marketplace on our website. And it's going to be, you know, geographically, it'll take you to which tab on the website, depending on the region and where our warehouse is located for the shipment of the whiskey to your home. And of course, you know, you're going to have to verify your age, because the United States, the drinking age is 21. And when the package is delivered at home, of course, somebody over the legal drinking age would have to sign for and provide proof of age as well. And from there, we will also be implementing a reward system from the profits of the whiskey, bark whiskey itself. So as, you know, profits coming in, we will be airdropping holders. Now, it still hasn't been decided on how we will be gifting it per se, because we are still working back and forth with legal. And we were actually on a Twitter space, and we are connecting with a brewery that's a local brewery in the United States that's actually implementing the same thing. And they've already figured out with legal the best reward system for their holders. And also, as the bark whiskey becomes more and more successful and more globally known, our royalties will be dropped to zero, because we will be self-sustaining. And that doesn't mean that we need our secondary sales to continue the project. It's more for us kind of expenses on the back end, paying our moderators, our community managers, and all along those lines, and doing giveaways and a DAO. So none of those actual secondary sales will be going to the whiskey side itself, because the whiskey side itself will be taking care of its own.
Kobe. Yeah, another question. If you send us, like, for example, a free bark whiskey bottle, would we pay customs for it? Also covered that charge?
That is all covered by us. And this is why, where I mean warehousing. So, for example, when it comes into the United States, we're already paying our excise tax. And at the same time, where our warehouses are located, we are also paying a state tax as well. So it would just be, if, let's say, for example, through our website, it would just be the fee after your discount that you would pay. There's no additional unless, like, for example, actually the United States, I believe there's no sales tax. I mean, I can only speak for New Jersey because each state itself does sales tax differently. And I know that New Jersey does not tax, I believe it does not tax liquor sales. But that's something that you guys would have to pay. Now, the import and the excise tax and the VAT tax for us bringing in the whiskey itself would all be paid by us.
Thank you for your answer.
Awesome. All right. So my last question, at least, I don't know if anyone else has any questions. When can I expect to have a whiskey bottle in my hand in the Europe?
Sure. So our recent projections from the distillery itself said we should have bottles once the label is approved within about 60 to 90 days. The whiskey itself is ready to go, but we actually are getting our bottles done. Instead of like your traditional sticker label, we're actually going to get our bottles heat pressed. So the label itself is going to be melted onto the bottle instead of just slapping a sticker on it. And then from there, so we're actually just adding 30 days. And the reason we say this is because of everything going on in the world and, you know, with delays and everything that, you know, we don't want to say, yeah, it's 60 to 90 days, but, you know, it might happen on the 95th day. So we're saying 90 to 100 days in those projections. It should be about the end of December to, you know, early January of 2023 that we should actually be able to provide bottles in hand.
Perfect. Looking forward to that. All right, Kobe, you have a question?
Would your free bottles be available worldwide or only for the U.S.?
So it would be available in the U.K. and the European Union, but that's not to say that we're not going to be giving, as we enter more global markets, that we would still be providing those markets and those community members with free bottles. So it will be an ongoing process as we expand globally. So for example, Canada and Australia, China and India are next markets that we're going to go after in that order. And it's all based on whiskey consumption per capita. So we've spoken with our lawyers and we've looked at charts of, you know, per country whiskey consumption per population, and from there we will be going down that list and entering those markets I want.
Kobe, you got another question, my man?
No, not a question. An update about sales tax. Yes, most of the states in the US actually do have sales tax for liquor. Just an update, because you didn't know.
Yeah,
just check.
Yeah. So, thank you. Yeah, because I know every state in the U.S. has different what they do tax, but that's, once again, that would actually be paid by the customer. That wouldn't be for us. That's like any good that you purchase in the U.S. You know, whether you're purchasing a TV, that would just be added onto the customer itself. But thank you for looking that up. I probably should have done that myself.
Awesome. All right. So, Moonshine, anything else you're excited about? Anything you want to share with everyone listening?
I mean, like I said in early on, it's just quite simple. You know, we're trying to bring Web2 and Web3 together. And what's two things in the world that, you know, whether anything that's going on actually go up in sales, and especially during a recession? It's tobacco sales and alcohol sales. And a lot of people, you know, when you're at gatherings, they don't, you know, they come together, but what do? They drink. And the easiest way to kind of bring people and more eyes to Web3 is providing a brand that's a household name, not just your traditional, hey, we're going to do a small batch and, you know, just sell it to the Web3. No, we're going after the global market. And by doing that, it would bring more attention to Web3 and to NFTs themselves.
Yeah, for sure. 100% agree. And looking forward to seeing you guys doing some onboarding here, getting the whiskey drinkers, buying our NFTs. Kobe,
Yeah, last question. Have you already gotten PGAs, TTB, and FDA, like the labels on the bottle that you're allowed to import to basically anywhere? Plus, after you have, because basically there are two parts of importing, because my family owns like the biggest chain of supermarkets I know a lot. Basically, there are two parts, right? There's the legal part where you need to go through the actual state, like in the US, and get a grill. And then there's the second part, which is done just by like one company for liquor, I don't know, but they usually have like the sticker thingy. Two stickers usually. One is for US and the other sticker is for Asia and Eurasia, basically. So have you already gone through that?
So we're actually going to be dropping our label designs today in an announcement and allow the community to decide what our label design company has come up with. So yes and no to the label side, that we haven't submitted them for approvals yet because we've been going back and forth in designs and we've narrowed it down to about 5 or 6 of them. That we are going to allow the community to decide how our bottle will look like. And with the import and wholesale licenses, yes. So our TTV license is still pending approval. We are just waiting to get scheduled for our interview. That's actually something they started doing this year. Before, it was just kind of an onboard process where they would do background checks on us, making sure, you know, we don't haven't done anything illegal in the past. But they actually started implementing an interview process, and we are currently just waiting to be scheduled for our interview for our TTB license, for our import license, and our wholesale license approvals. Do you have a follow-up question?
Yes.
You can shoot.
Okay. So that means you still need to go through patent and trademark office, right? Am I correct?
So actually our trademarks, I believe, have been filed already. That's something that we are also going to be providing before the whiskey. I know legal is supposed to be handling all of trademarks for us and, you know, people approvals, and they're handling our TTB license as well. And that's also our pending review and application number for TTB will also be included in the announcement today as well. So we will be providing additional legal documentation about the Bark Whiskey brand itself.
Thank you very much for answering my question.
Perfect. All right, guys, any last question? Now we can also, like ClockMen, free to speak as well. If anyone has any questions, anything, inputs, now is a good time. You both have great, both hyped and exciting upcoming projects with substance behind it. So I'm looking forward to both you guys deliver on this. What goes into to both of you? You both have, as I said, like already popular collections. What goes into creating a, for anyone who want to create a NFT collection and has an idea of what they want to make, to creating this, from launching the Twitter to just getting people on board? Any tips? You can start, B-Rock.
Oh, gotcha. I mean, the easiest way to do it is the ideas, and this is kind of how we came about our idea, is everything, like a concept that you come up with, you need to actually look at it as a community member's eyes. So is it something that you'd be interested in minting? Would you be interested in holding an NFT of that project? And whether or not, how achievable it is. And the easiest way is just kind of getting out there, get your name out there, just join Twitter spaces, ask for feedback, be open, especially in the beginning, to criticism, you know, constructive criticism, and learn from it. Listen, none of us are perfect. None of us know everything. And anybody that says they do, they're full of shit.
Oh, God.
I agree. What about you, Chopin? What do you?
I agree 100%. Nobody should believe that they're the only one. That is entirely not the case. And whoever thinks that way will never last in this space.
Yep. And what about like allocating? That's also a question. I've never launched Asian. Maybe sometime in the future. Nothing planned now. Like allocating whitelist. Do you guys think a lot about this? How to touch the right people? Because I've seen so many collections that have 2,000 supply and 6,000 whitelists, and still the whitelist people doesn't mint.
Well, that is probably because I think the main reason for that is when projects reach out asking 10 whitelist spots, people try and give them 50 whitelist spots instead. And that's probably the main case scenario where they fail. They get rid of the exclusivity of it, and without the exclusivity, there's no true value.
I agree on that. And I mean, listen, we've seen a lot of over allocations and like surprise info with like mints. And the reason being, like with us, is, you know, we have like three different roles. So we actually have like an OG role, moonshine list, and a seller list. And they're pretty much all guaranteed mints. But the seller list would actually, it's not going to be an over allocation of like how many NFTs would be left. It's going to be like the exclusivity, because they can also mint two as well. So the over allocation doesn't come from the members itself. It comes down to whether they decide to mint one or two. And based on like speaking with our advisors, they wanted us to make it more of like a controlled whitelist mint, so that it's not heavily botted, because, you know, you can't purchase five of them. Or, you know, we've seen some people say like, oh, I just got whitelist on like 10 different accounts and just botted it and got 100 of it.
I think that's what a horrible way to start your product with a few people sitting on a big part of the supply. That's a great advice. All right. Do you want to say something?
No, I was just going to say, like, I think all projects should have like a limitation for someone, like they're not able to buy more than like 3 or 5 max.
Yeah, I agree. They can buy a secondary if they want more.
Exactly.
That's the key. All right. We're going to round it up. We've been going for an hour. This has been super interesting. Very excited to see you guys deliver on this, everything you've told us today. Just for everyone listening, looking to get involved, want to get a whitelist, what do they do?
I don't know why it wasn't letting me unmute. So basically, the easiest way to gain access to our whitelist is to use our networking chats and successfully either hire someone or be hired by someone or create a partnership. And so like mainly we're targeting so people with Web3 skills. So the only really like way to get into our private Discord is if you have one of those skills, or if you're a part of a strong community or DAO. And so once you're in, so it's, there's a lot of exclusivity there. I think we'll open it up for like periods of time where like people can get into the Discord, and we'll target like specific builder communities. So like right when we drop our private Discord link, they'll be ready. So those builder communities will go right in, and we'll be able to kind of select the people with Web3 skills for our whitelist. And I think that's how it should be, because the people without Web3 skills will come in the public sale, and we can't really avoid those. So I think for our whitelist, we have to try as hard as possible to maintain that exclusivity through only Web3 skills.
Awesome. What about you, B-Rock?
So for us, you know, we've actually dropped a requirement, like not like a requirement, but like the first 100 that are like inviting members. But we've typically just been rewarding active members in our chat, those that seem passionate enough that want to be there, whether, you know, it's just chatting with us. And it's not like a daily grind where we're saying, hey, like, you need to message us every day. Like, no, those that are asking us questions, you know, we're always in voice chat. Our artist actually has been in the voice chat for the past 4 days, live drawing attributes. And, you know, we've been rewarding community members there, those that, you know, we do giveaways, games. You know, we're not, you know, listen, everybody doesn't have the time of day to just sit there and chat, you know, 8-6 hours a day. And we understand that. And, you know, we want a community that, whether or not that they can be on Discord every day, but will be there, you know, when we have that announcement, that, you know, want to be an active member in the community as much as they can, versus, you know, a bot coming in and just spamming the chat for 20 hours to get level 20 and say, oh, look, I got level 20. Please award me my whitelist.
Yeah, that's very healthy. And I know Future, you have been in there talking with the artists, right?
No, I don't want to talk to you, bro. I'm so upset right now. You told me this was Wednesday. I was over in the Bad Cat space talking to Underground DAO. And then I pop over here to see, oh, I'm ready for tomorrow. And I'm like, wait, these guys are in here, bro. I was like, man,
I was testing you. You failed.
Yeah, I don't follow on the pod's tweets, bro. I'm all over the place. I put the screenshot up there. I'm ready. I missed the whole thing, bro. I just came in like 3 minutes ago. I'll catch him on another one. I'm bullish.
We have a saying, you sleep and you miss out. That's what we live by.
The screenshot's right there, bro. We have them next Wednesday. Unless, I don't know. Man.
Do you want to know the best part, Future? This is a recorded space, and it will also be on like different platforms. So you can play it back whenever you want to.
I was just going to add that.
Yeah. Just,
so you're good, Future.
Well, I wanted to be able to ask on some of the topics that they talk about, but I'll have to get my notebook and write down some of the stuff they touched on, and then I'll go into VC and ask the team, and
yep,
I'll get it done. Yep.
Who knows? Maybe they had a good experience here and want to come back another time. Who knows?
For sure.
Definitely.
Awesome. All right. So, ClockMen and V-Rock, thank you so much for coming on. Super excited. I'm going to see. We have our professional alpha whitelist hunter who reached out to all the greatest projects in this space and gets me and everyone in the pod Discord access to everything. So I'm definitely going to ask her if she has been reaching out to you, and otherwise we'll probably be in touch because I need to get on these. But thank you so much, guys. Tomorrow, for everyone, our community, when I come back tomorrow, we're going to have the Castle and maybe A2C DAO with us. Castle is an upcoming collection. A2C DAO, I don't know, TK. You know, is that an upcoming collection?
It's their second collection.
Yeah, they have the... Yeah, I know. All right, awesome. Thanks, everyone who has been asking questions, all the speakers, everyone listening.
Yeah, thank you for hosting us, and hopefully I'm back soon.
Yes, for sure.
And thank you for having us.
Yeah, anytime. Shoot the DM anytime you want to come back. And it would be cool to see, like, once you guys have minted, we have some whiskey to order, for example, or some educations to have you guys on again. Also, shout out to our sponsor for the night, Hyperlaunch. You guys both have upcoming collections, so this is perfect for you. Jack is an amazing developer, a guy we talk a lot with as well, who has the Chainbreaker collection. Hyperlaunch is the launchpad for this collection, which with the intention for anyone to be able to launch their collection without writing any code. And he specializes in the, let's say, minting experience. So you can get a personalized mint page with your whiskey or your clocks and make it look sick, with also some very good pricing. So I would love to get you guys in touch with him. So for that, Jack. Otherwise, as always, after this, we're going to open our after party where we can hang out and talk about everything. So again, guys, thank you so much for coming on, and see you later or tomorrow. See you guys. Until it up.
No.